Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to time remap your clips just like this on Premiere Pro. Let's begin by preparing your sequence. If you are using raw clips like me, and you'll be able to know if it's raw because it will look more choppy, or should I say natural, compared to twixted or time remapped clips. So this is an example of a 23 or 24 frames per second clip directly taken from the actual episode itself, so it hasn't been frame interpolated, compared to a scene pack like this, which has very clearly been interpolated from a lower frame rate all the way up to 60 frames per second. So if you are using a 60 FPS scene pack or 60 FPS clips, then you don't have to change your sequence frame rate. You can leave it at 60. So if you head to the top, head over to sequence settings, you can leave the time base at 60 frames per second for your main sequence. However, if you are going to be using raw clips just like me, then what you want to do is change it to 23.976 or 24. Sometimes one works, the other doesn't, but 23.976 is recommended. So feel free to pause the video and copy my exact settings. I'm going to hit OK. And don't worry, you can change your edits back to 60 frames per second later on. Okay, so that's step one done. The next thing you need to do is prepare your clips. So go through your scene pack and pick out the clips, drag them onto your timeline. Ideally, you want the clip to have some sort of motion, so you can see all of these have movement. If they don't, or maybe just one or two don't have it, then that's fine, don't worry about it. The next thing we need to do is nest each of our clips. And also, for the sake of this tutorial, I'm not going to be using any music because copyrights, so instead, I'm going to be placing markers directly onto my timeline. And we're going to pretend that those are the beats of the music that we want the clips to match to. So for instance, I'm just going to place a few around here. Let's go for maybe here, a few frames ahead, one here, and then maybe let's go for this one here, and then one more. All right, nest every clip. So right click, nest, okay. Or if you have a hotkey assigned, just use that. So I've got Control N. So I'm just going to nest every single clip. All done. And now what we can do is head over to sequence at the top, sequence settings, and change the time base to either 30, if that's what you prefer, or 60. I'm going to use 60 because it's smoother, and click OK. So now if I open up one of these nested sequences, you'll notice that the frame rate is still 23.976, which matches the original frame rate of my clips. Did you know what would happen if I left it at 60? It would turn out looking like this. And you've probably seen edits look like this in the past. I've just done you a favor to prevent that issue happening in the future. All right, now it's time to do the actual time remapping. So what you want to do is expand the clip so we can get a closer look. You can either just expand the video track manually by hovering over this bar here. So just click and drag and you can expand, or you can just hold Alt on your keyboard and use the mouse wheel to do it like this. And then what we want to do is right click on the effects box. So right here, you'll see it says FX. It's a very tiny box. So right click on that, select time remapping and speed. What I'm going to do first is just move these out the way. So second clip on the second marker. In fact, I might do that with my other clips as well. So I'm just going to move this to that one. And okay, well, I can't really match this one with the third because this clip is in the way. So I can just cut this down. It doesn't really matter. Then push it forwards and extend. Perfect. So the kind of speed ramp or result that I'm looking for is for it to start off very quick and then slow down towards the middle, then speed back up towards the end. And I'm going to repeat this with my other clips. So to begin with your first one, you want to head to the first frame, actually head to the second frame. So just one frame ahead, you want to hold Control on your keyboard until this plus icon appears. So if I hold Control, you can see my cursor changes. Then you want to click, and that's going to place a keyframe. You'll notice that there are two points on it. It's like kind of split down the middle. So if I grab it on the right side, so this one right here, and pull it to the right, you can see we've kind of like broken it apart. This works as a barrier. I don't really know how to explain, but for example, this half here, so after this keyframe, you can modify the speed to what you like. For example, I could just click it. So this bar right here, and I can decrease the speed to slow it down or increase it to speed it up. But on the other side, just before this keyframe here, you can also do the same, but it's only going to affect that side. So you can kind of see where I'm going with this. So as I said before, it speeds up, or at least it starts off fast and then slows down. So it would only slow down if this percentage was lower at something like 50 or 20, which results in a ramp that looks like this because it's gradually slowing down over time. That was just an explanation, so don't copy what I just did. What you want to do is place another keyframe. So after you place this first one, place another towards the end. Also, you might see this weird texture here. That just means the clip is too short and you can't extend it further, but don't worry about that just yet. So place a keyframe somewhere around the end. It doesn't have to be the last frame. So I'm just going to place one around here. Hold control and click. So now you should have two in total. With the first one, what I'm going to do is drag it. So the right side, I'm going to drag it to the right somewhere around here. And then for the one at the end, I'm going to drag the left side. So not the right, because that won't work. Well, it actually did work, but I wouldn't recommend doing it because it can mess things up. So just try and grab the left side and put it to the left. Remember what I said. So starts off fast, slows down, speeds back up. So this middle part here, what we're going to do is hold shift on our keyboard and then click and drag this bar here between the keyframes. So click and drag it down. By holding shift, we can lock into multiples of 5. So all I'm doing is dragging it down whilst holding shift. So you can pick something like 50% or go even lower if you want it to look slower. So for this example, let's go for 50 only. Ah, where's my keyframes? It's all gone. No, don't worry. It's just over there. So all you need to do is just drag it. So you'll see this icon here if you just hover over your keyframes like that. So just drag them to the left. If you can't, then just keep on trying. It might just be really far. Or what you can do is just move your other clips out of the way, extend the clip, and then try and drag them back. But mine are already here, which is great. So what I'm going to do is just bring this keyframe forwards a little, and then I'm just going to extend this more, push this back, and extend this a bit more. Okay, you can see my clip is a little short here. You can either fix this by just opening up the nested sequence, so double click on it to open it up, and you can just extend it, assuming you want to include this part of the clip in your remap. If you don't, then don't extend the clip. Instead, what you want to do is just decrease the speed in the middle. So right now we're using 50%, so I'm going to hold shift. You can dip to something lower like 30 or 25, and that works as an alternative. And for some reason, a random keyframe might appear at the end. I didn't place this. I don't know where it came from. This always happens. So you can just get rid of it. I have no idea who placed that. It wasn't me. So you can just click and then press delete on your keyboard. Or you can just head over to effect controls at the top, right click, clear. Okay, so this is the finished result. And you'll notice, well, it looks choppy. And that's because we need to render a preview. But before we do that, you want to right click on the clip, head over to speed/duration. And change the time interpolation from frame sampling to optical flow and click OK. Then you want to head to the start of the clip, press I on your keyboard, head to the last frame, press O on your keyboard. Then you want to head over to sequence at the top, sequence settings. And if you haven't already copied my video preview settings, then pause the video and do that right now. Preview file formats, QuickTime, codec, Apple ProRes 422, click on reset. Uncheck both of these boxes and check this one about linear color. Then click OK, and what you want to do is head back into sequence and select render into out, which is only going to render this segment here so we can get a preview. So render into out, shouldn't take too long. And there you go. So that is how it looks so far. I will say it does look quite smooth, but I'm not really seeing a remap on it. So let's go further and slow it down even more. So what I'm going to do is head to the middle and hold shift on my keyboard. Then I'm going to drag this bar down to something as low as, let's try 10%. Let's see how that will look. And oh, my keyframes, they're gone again. Great. So I'm just going to have to push this forward and find them. Ah, there they are. Perfect. Just follow my steps. So what I'm going to do is push this keyframe back. Again, it's gone. So what I'm going to do is not push these back. I'm going to drag these back first. Then slowly drag it back as well. It can be a little bit tricky to work with, and well, not just tricky, but it can just be really annoying overall. But everything sorted. One more thing I do want to do, so I might have to move them around again. So I do want the beginning and end to be faster than they are right now. So starting with the end, actually, what I'm going to do is first of all just right click here, and select clear in to out so we don't have those points in the way. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is, first of all, hold shift on my keyboard, click and drag this part here at the end up. So click, let's go for something like 200. Sure, why not? I'm just going to extend this and then do the same for the other side. So just here, not this part here. In fact, it won't even work. So just click. So hold shift, click and drag up. Let's go for 200 as well, like that. Then I'm just going to readjust my keyframes like so. Might take a little while and it can be really annoying. You have to keep stretching them out and then moving them. For example, I can't even move this keyframe forwards. It just won't work. So I think what I can do instead is just tighten these up, push it forwards maybe, and then drag it. Yeah, that kind of works. I have to keep on doing that. Yeah, just like that. All right, all done. So what I'm going to do is I on my keyboard and then O on the last frame. Then I'm going to render a preview and hopefully this should look really good. That looks perfect. However, it's going to look even better with our other clips with the time remap as well. So yeah, that's pretty much done. What we can do is just clear into out and repeat this with your other clips. So I'm going to do it with my second one, time remap speed, place a keyframe at the start. So I need to make sure that the clip does not go over this marker here. So I've just placed two keyframes. I'll just show you that again. So right there or there, doesn't really matter. Then I'm going to expand like so and then push this down holding shift. So let's go to 25 instead because it's quite short anyway. It doesn't really matter. I'm just going to push it back. And okay, I can't drag this one for some reason, so I'm just going to push that one back first like so. Looks good. Just need to speed them up from both sides. Forgot about that completely. So all the way up to 200%. Gonna extend. Oh, I can't extend it. Maybe I should use a lower percentage on both sides. So instead of 200, let's go 150. And then what I'm going to do if that still doesn't work is just extend the clip manually. So yeah, that's not really working. And that's already as low as it can be. That was what, 25%. So I'm just going to extend it. I mean, it shouldn't be too bad, I think. So yeah, around here, that keyframe appeared again. So I'm going to delete that, extend, and okay, yeah, perfect. That kind of fixed it. So I'm just going to keep on pushing these forward around here. Looks great. So I'm just going to cut this down around here. Let's see how this one looks as well. So in fact, what I'm going to do is, have I done this already? I think I did, but I'm going to check anyway. I'm going to render both of these. So sequence render into out. Oh, I forgot completely. Right click the second clip, speed slash duration, and optical flow for the time interpolation. That's why it looks so choppy. So I'm going to try again. Yep, it looks great. But one thing I noticed is that this kind of ramp doesn't look good on short clips. I think, well, obviously, you know, it depends on the style. So if you don't want to make it speed up towards the end, what you can do is just get rid of this keyframe. And then what you can do is just drag this one. So the first one, drag it towards the end. And all that it's going to do is just slow down. That's it. Simple as that. But now it looks really quick. So I'm just going to turn the speed down, crank it to about 100, push this back, cut it down even more like that. Okay, let's do render into out. And that's the result. To finish it off, I do recommend nesting your clip in case you do apply any effects onto them directly. So for each one, right click and only do this once you're done with the time remapping. Otherwise, you might have to take it out and then redo it and it can be a bit tricky to work with. So right click, nest, okay, repeat with the other clips and you're pretty much done. Thank you very much for watching. If you're interested, then check out this video here. Anyways, I hope this tutorial helped and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.